Assalamu alaikum my dear students. Hope you are all fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome back to our English class. Today we are going to start lesson number 9 of your textbook and the title of this lesson is Dream Palace. And my dear students, our today's activity will be comprehension of this play. Actually it's not a story, it's in the form of a play, in the form of dialogues. There are dialogues of every character and dear students, we will be trying to understand this play scene after scene. Like we have different episodes of a serial, likewise we have different scenes of this play. So dear kids, let's get started. Dear students, this is the lesson number 9 of your textbook, Dream Palace. And it's page number 90. Okay, dear kids, you know what is a dream. Something that we see or something that we perceive when we are sleeping. And palaces, a place, a luxurious house where a king lives. Okay? See dear students, this is the picture of a palace. It's a luxurious, grand, spacious house where a king lives. Okay? This is one more picture of a palace. It's a grand building. Grand building, grand structure where a king lives. Okay, so dear kids, today we are going to try to understand this play Dream Palace. First, the characters: King Krishnadevarya, Tenali Raman, and ministers, some ministers. So the main characters are King Krishnadevarya, Tenali Raman, and the ministers. Ministers are the people who work in a king's court. Now let's get started. Once upon a time, King Krishnadevarya ruled over the Vijayanagar kingdom. Tenali Raman was the court jester. Stories about Tenali Raman and his tricks on everyone around him, including the king, are quite well known. In the play, King Krishnadevarya summons all his ministers to the court to make an important announcement. Read on to find out what happens next. So it's a story long times back. So there used to be a king whose name was King Krishnadevarya, and he ruled over this Vijayanagar kingdom. The area over which he ruled, the name of that territory was Vijayanagar. And Tenali Raman, he was his court jester. Jester is somebody who is having good sense of humor, who is having the ability to make others laugh. So he was present, he worked in the king's court, but as a jester, he was supposed to be there just to make others laugh. And there are so many famous stories about Tenali Raman, how he tricked everybody, how he made everybody laugh, including the king. Okay, now in this play, in this story, we will see that King Krishnadevarya, he summons is officially called, like at our homes our parents call us, come here, but summon is official legal call. Like if somebody has done a crime, there is a summon, there is an order from the police station or from the court to appear there, so that is called a summon. And here King Krishnadevarya, he summons all his ministers. He calls all his ministers to the court to make some important kind of announcement. Now let's see what the announcement is and what happens next. So the first scene, okay, scene 1. I told you, like, we have episodes in TV serials. Likewise, we have scenes here, okay. The king's palace. So the scene is in king's palace. Now Krishnadevarya, last night I had a marvelous dream. I dreamed of a beautiful palace. It was made of glittering stones and floated in the air. So Krishnadevarya is telling all the ministers that last night he had a marvelous, a wonderful dream. And what he dreamed, he saw a beautiful palace in his dream. And what was the special quality of that palace? That it was made up of shining stones and it floated in the air. It was not present on the earth. It was not made on the earth, but it was floating. Like if we leave a balloon, won't it float in the air? So likewise, or if we have a kite, doesn't it float in there? Yes, but this dream palace, the palace that he saw in dream, it also floated in the air. Now you see Krishnadevarya, he is talking to his ministers about this palace that he had dreamed about. Okay, now minister 1, that's wonderful, your majesty. Now see this minister, he is praising his king. Oh majesty, what a wonderful dream you had. Krishnadevarya, yes, the palace had everything that one could ever wish for. It could be lit up with 1,000 lights or made to disappear into the darkness in a second. Now Krishnadevaraya is telling that this palace, the palace I saw in my dream or I dreamed about, it was very wonderful. Everybody would like to have one such palace. And what was the good quality about this palace? That if all the lights were lit up, were turned on in this palace, it could be made visible. And if all the lights were turned off, and the palace disappeared in the darkness. Minister to, O noble king, may your dream come true. See, they are praising their king. They are trying to please their king. But these are all false praises. Okay? O noble king, may your dream come true. Is it true that we can build a palace in air? No. Whatever structure, whatever building, whatever we have to make, we have to make it on earth. It can't be made in the air. Now, Minister Third, our ruler's dreams are as spectacular as his actions. Now, he is again flattering his king. He is again falsely praising his king. He is saying that like our king is wonderful, special, his dreams are also special. Krishnadevaraya, I woke up suddenly, but I have not forgotten the dream palace. Now, Krishnadevaraya is telling them that I have woken up suddenly, but I have not forgotten that dream palace yet. It is still on my mind. I will give 100,000 gold coins to anyone who can build such a palace for me. So Krishnadevaraya is telling the ministers that I'll give 100,000 gold coins to anybody who can build me such a palace. The ministers stop mid-sentence. Their mouths fall open. Now, when the ministers got to hear the wish of King Krishnadevaraya, they stopped amid silence. There is complete silence in the court and they are all stunned. Means they are all now nervous what to do, how to make this wish true. Minister one, aside, no palace floats in air. Now see, the minister, he is not telling on face that Krishnadevaraya, this palace can't exist. No, he is telling to himself, he is telling to other ministers in a slow tone, no palace floats in air. Now minister two, aside, but who has the courage to tell him that? Now another minister, he is also saying, but who will tell the King Krishnadevaraya that such a palace cannot be built? Minister 4 hesitantly, but now see this Minister 4, he gathered some courage. Now hesitantly, not so boldly, but hesitantly, he says, Your Majesty, such a palace cannot be real. It can only exist in one's mind. See, these two ministers, they were not enough bold to tell the king that such a palace cannot be built. But this Minister 4, he gathered some courage and hesitantly he told the king that this palace cannot be real and it cannot be built. Krishnadevaraya shouting, how dare you oppose my wishes? Leave my court at once now. Krishnadevaraya, when he heard the fourth minister's reply, he shouted at him, how dare you went against my wishes? How could you say this? Leave my court. Get out of here. Okay? Minister 4 exits. He leaves the court. Turning to other ministers, my palace must be built. I command you to find me a builder to create the palace of my dream. All of you will be punished if you fail to do so. Now see this Krishnadevaraya, he is telling, turning to other ministers means now he is addressing the other ministers. He is telling them that whatever palace I have dreamed about, it should be built. And I command you, I order you all to find a builder who can create, who can construct such a dream of my such a palace of my dream. And if you fail to get me such a builder, I will punish you all. Now he threatens to punish them. Okay? Scene second, the king's palace. The ministers are worried. The next day they ask Tenali Raman for help. Now second scene, again it's in king's palace. All the ministers are now worried. They are afraid. What shall we do? How, where from can we get such a builder who can build a palace in the air? Now on the next day they went to Tenali Raman for help. Minister 1, you must do something. Now first minister is telling Tenali Raman that you must do something. Minister 2, the king will punish severely if the palace is not built. Second minister is also telling that the king will punish us very severely. He will punish us in a strict way if the palace is not built. Third minister, please help us Tenali, only you can make the king understand that it is impossible to build such a palace. Now third minister is also telling Tenali Raman that please and please help us, otherwise none other you can help us in making the king understand that we can't build such a palace. Tenali Raman, I need some time to think of a solution. Don't worry, let me see what I can do. So now Tenali Raman is telling them that give me some time to think. Don't worry, I will see whatever I can do to help you. Now third scene, the king's palace. The next day, a very old man came to the king's court. Now another day, and an old man came to king's court. old man, "Oh my gracious king, I have come to you to ask for justice. I am sure that your majesty will help me." Now this old man, he is telling the king that, "Oh my gracious king," he is showing, it is a way of showing respect for the king. He is telling him that he has come to seek justice there. And he told him that he was sure that the king will definitely help him. "Krishna Devariya, what is the problem? Tell me without fear and I shall see that justice is done." Now Krishna Devariya is asking the old man, "What is your problem? Don't be afraid. Tell me clearly. I will see that justice is done." "Old man, unhappily, thieves have looted me, your majesty. All my savings are gone. I have nothing left." Now this old man, he is telling Krishna Devariya that thieves have looted me. They have stolen everything from me, all the savings, whatever I have saved during my lifetime, it is all gone. They have taken all of that. I have nothing left. Okay? Krishna Devariya angrily, "Who has looted you? Name them and I'll punish them immediately." Now Krishna Devariya became angry. He told him, he asked him, "Who has looted you? Who has taken, who has stolen all your belongings or all your savings? You tell us the names. We will punish them immediately, right now." "Old man, my just king, I'll tell you everything, but you must promise not to punish me if my answer upsets you." Old man tells Krishna Devariya that, "Okay king, I will tell you, but promise me that after listening my answer, after hearing my reply, you won't get angry on me or you won't punish me." Krishna Devariya impatiently, "Yes, yes, I promise." Now Krishna Devariya told him, "Okay, I promise, I won't be angry with you, I won't punish you." Old man softly, "It's you, sir." Now old man told him that, "Sir, king, it is you who has stolen my savings." Krishna Devariya stands up angrily, "How dare you?" He remembers his promise and sits down again. "Let me hear what you have to say. Continue." Now he stood up angrily. He told him, "How dare you call me a thief?" But again he remembers his promise not to be angry with the old man. So he sits down and tells him, "Let me hear you continue what you want to say." "Old man, last night I dreamed that you and your ministers stole my entire life savings, 5,000 gold coins." Now old man told him that, "I also dreamed that you and your ministers, they stole all my life savings, whatever I have saved throughout my life, 5,000 gold coins, you and your ministers stole that." Krishna Devariya laughing, "You are a fool. How can you think your dream is real? Dreams are not true." Now Krishna Devariya is telling him, "You are a fool. Are you mad? How can you think your dream is real? Dreams can never be true." Old man smiling, "But they are, your majesty. If your dream of a palace hanging in the air can come true, why can't my dream come true?" Now old man is smiling at the king and telling him that, "If you are dreaming of a palace that is floating in the air, if it can come true, then why not my dream can come true?" Krishna Devariya astonished, "What are you saying? Who are you?" Now Krishna Devariya, he is very surprised. He is telling him, "What are you saying? Who are you?" The old man removes his beard and hair and stands before the king. It is none other than Tenali Raman. So here, this old man, he was wearing false beard and hair. He stood before the king and it was Tenali Raman. He removed his false hair and beard. And who was there? It was Tenali Raman. Krishna Devariya confused, "Is that you, Tenali Raman? What is the meaning of this?" Now Krishna Devariya, he was very puzzled. He told Tenali Raman, "Is it you? What is the meaning of all this drama?" Tenali Raman, bowing low, he bowed a little. "Forgive me, my king, for tricking you." He sought king's forgiveness because he has tricked the king. And he told him that this was the only way to show you that your wish was totally absurd. It was senseless. The wish you had to get a palace built in the air, floating palace, it was totally senseless. Krishna Devariya laughing, "You are right, Tenali. You are really very clever. Thank you for making me realize how unreasonable my wish was." So finally Krishna Devariya realized that whatever wish he was having to get a palace built in the air, floating palace, it was totally unreasonable. It was not fair. And he thanked Tenali for making him understand that his wish was unreasonable. Okay, so dear students, this was the play Dream Palace. You again go through the dialogues of this lesson and also try to enact this play. Involve your friends or your siblings and try to enact this play. Okay, take good care of yourselves. Allah Hafiz.